So, guys, when I have talked to Obama aides on this issue, I talked to Dan Pfeiffer, I talked to Jay Carney over the past years, talked about this. They tell me all that Syria is the issue that haunts Obama the most. How could it not? 500,000 people died while we did nothing. Bill Clinton says his biggest regret was not intervening in Rwanda early. But even if you don't care about the tragedy of this, the horrific war crimes, the humanitarian cost, ignoring all of this, the chemical weapons, ISIS, Al-Qaeda, Hezbollah, Iran, Russia, ignoring all of it, it just gets worse. Isn't it time to do something in a full-throated way?
I think that's a really good question. And it's impossible to tell while you're doing something interventionist whether or not what the outcome is going to be. So here's
But it is possible to tell what doing nothing will be.
Exactly.
Because we know now.
Totally. But one of the things that was on the list that Tillerson laid out that I thought was, I guess, interesting was the idea of replacing Bashar al-Assad.
Yeah.
And the idea that whoever replaces him will somehow be in any way better than him.
Right.
Anytime there's a power vacuum in an area where there was that many different ideologies and that many different kind of disparate forces fighting, I worry about what the alternative is.
Sure.
And I mean, I'm not going to pretend to have any answers here, but that's something that is a concern.
Well, and it would definitely, and that's my next question to you, Dave, all of the things that Tillerson wants to do, rid Syria of WMDs, return Syrian refugees to Syria, something that I've been working on for a really long time. All of that is completely possible if you get rid of Assad. But what next? And he does not answer who replaces Assad, what comes after Assad, what does post-Assad look like, post-Assad Syria look like. None of that is answered here, and I believe that is a problem.
Basically, what he wants is regime change, which has been an absolute
yes.
nightmare everywhere that we've had it. And the idea that we're going to go into a civil war and take both sides out is, of all of these wars, the most ridiculous plan that I've heard yet. And as far as standing back while hundreds of thousands of people die, no one seems to have a problem with doing that in Yemen right now, because it's not the regime that we want to overthrow. It's the regime we support doing it. This is insane. ISIS did not rise because we pulled out of Iraq because of a bad decision. We pulled out on Bush's timeline because we had to, because the government of Iraq was no longer going to protect our troops against war crimes. ISIS rose because we overthrew Saddam Hussein and then we armed ISIS. We need to not intervene in this part of the world. It's an immoral war. It's an illegal war. Syria has not attacked America. We have no legitimate reason for our defense to be there. And this is exactly what Bush promised not to do, what Obama promised not to do, and what Trump promised not to do.
Well, least of all, I mean, I disagree with almost everything you just said, which is fine. But so do a lot of Trump supporters. And so it's interesting that Trump has sort of, like, you know, quietly closed the door on his America First agenda with this.
Can I make one really easy prediction? Whatever weapons or training we furnish to any side of this conflict will one day be used against us.
Most likely.